Like 16. Which, you know, is this a big map? Okay, they were also quite close. So let me just up the scoreboard, fellas. Wrong button. So the SDC is on the left. Let me move this as well. There we are. Just because, of course, OBS doesn't really allow for scoreboards. So, let's do the introduction to everyone. Spawning in the top right. He did lose the last map. And, of course, he is 0-2 down in this best of 9 so far. It is the red Protoss ESC Daisy. And then, on the other side of the map, at the top left, spawning is the blue Terran. Playing for complexity, it is the STC. And, of course, he is 2-0 up so far in this best of 9. He still needs 3 more games in a row to win this. So, I wonder what will happen. Like I said, this is quite a big map. They're close by air, near enough. I guess that's close by ground as well. And yeah, you know, we can see a lot of aggression come out from here. It's not going to be as effective drop play, I don't think, to get between like the main and natural like we saw from him last couple of games. So that could be good. Of course, getting from this drop to the, from this base to the main will be very annoying for Daisy to deal with, if that is what the STC is going for. Okay, so far he's gone for a gas around now for his Reapers, and I wonder if he'll be going for that or if it's going to be like a gasless expansion. He doesn't have Lon, so I think he wants to mix it up. I wonder what Daisy will do. Daisy, of course, has opened Stargate, or gone to open Stargate every game. Last game, he unfortunately got scouted. That was some really impressive scouting from the STC, I gotta admit. Alright, so we have one gas from Daisy. So it looks like a one Rex expansion v a one gate expansion. And no gas, of course, for the Terran player. So, an even faster expansion. Very nice indeed. Here it comes. Drop Marines in production, and yeah, it's gotta be that. Yeah, okay, there we are. The probe isn't coming to build it, so yeah, that is 100%. We have the scout coming from the SDC, and he is, of course, scouting anti clockwise, which is bad for him because now he will, you know, be late to scout his opponent. So, never mind. What is Daisy doing? Is he scouting anti clockwise or clockwise? It looks like clockwise, but no. It's anti-clockwise. So, yeah, they're both having a little bit of a late scout. We do have 2 Marines. These are interesting. Okay, they're on patrol just to make sure nothing funky happens. No interesting timing comes out of Daisy and kills the SDC. We do have Warp Gate being chrono boosted pretty fast. So, I wonder if there's going to be some sort of Warp Gate build. The Mothership Core is not even in production yet. So, that's curious as well. Second gas getting dropped. And for the SCC, both gases in production, second and third racks in production, the command center is nearly complete. So he is doing a completely standard wall, one racks gasless expand, which, you know, I expected at some point. So yeah, that's totally standard. Bunker now incoming, and this SCV has not scouted yet. This map is huge. It's taken him like 5 minutes just to scout. And I wonder if he'll see the expansion. It should. There's only one Stalker. The second Stalker is at the top of the ramp, so that's not going to be able to do some damage. So yeah, this will get spotted just about. There it is. So you saw that, no problem. And 2 more gateways. These will finish up roughly with Warp Gate. Yeah, not far off Warp Gate. We have a corner boost on the Warp Gate, so that is a bit unneeded. Seems these two aren't going to be finished. And this is quite your standard opening. Of course, you kind of have to have a Robo now because of the Widow Mines. You know, you can go Stargate and get an Oracle, but I find it to be inefficient for defensive purposes. 2 gateways do finish up the Robo. Still being added on. Gateways turning into Warp Gates. There is no proxy pylon apart from down here. So, I don't know what that is all about. We, obviously Daisy knows where his opponent is, so I think maybe a Twilight and a DT Shrine. I don't see a Stargate being added on this far down here. This could be just for later purposes, but no. It is a Twilight, and he will add on the TTs, it seems. Which is funky. It's pretty funky. I'm not going to say anything bad about that build. Because, of course, he hasn't gotten DTs into an expansion, so it's not like he's taken an economic hit to get them out. He's expanding with DTs. Or expanding then DTs. So this is funky, actually. And obviously, from the Terran player, we've got all the good stuff in production. Starport now being added on the reactor to swap with Starport itself. Bunker done, and we have plus one. Did I just see plus one? Oh no, it's the eBay. There we are, plus one now added on. Marine going for a little scout. If we'll see these units, it'll be a bit curious. We have an observer going for the scout, and the DT shrine should be added on. Should. He's a bit low on gas. He's got it now. There it is. And he takes... Well, he's already got his third and fourth gas, so his gas income is good. Now he's going to start banking it ready for the DTs. We have one forge and another pylon. Interesting place for a pylon. Seems it like the architecture of the buildings looks really odd now in comparison to a single pylon. But never mind, I'm not going to complain. I think this might be where the proxy pylon goes down for the DTs. We do have some units moving out across the map. Only 17 marines. It's a lot. It's not game ending, really. We do have, of course, enough NG for a photon overcharge. Force fields can lock them out. Photon overcharge can hit them, and he can drop a time warp. Two medevacs also out with his army, so we're going to have some drop play incoming. Daisy doesn't really know this is coming, so he has to be prepared. Photon overcharge is going to get dropped. It does. So one probe goes down there. The two medevacs are meeting up with this army. The proxy pylon has been dropped for the DTs, and a third base has been started, which is being scouted. That is a big deal. There's also an observer bay here, which is it going to come into play? I think it will. There's a big group of DTs, or five Stalkers. They can do some good damage. It does get spotted. And, of course, there is also some units that want to come into the natural and do some damage there. And nice reactions from the STC. The DT Shrine has finished. The DTs are being morphed in. We have four. I think it could be, a couple per base. Crap on button. I don't think STC spotted the DTs. And these are only Marines. Oh, nice force fields. He needs to go for them. Yeah, he does. He goes for the medevacs to stop them escaping. One medevac does escape and will pick up some Marines. Trying its best. Pylon is getting taken out, but we do have four DTs. This base is dead. We have one in the natural, two in the main. One of them getting targeted down, but it might just escape. No, it won't. But it is out of scan range now, so this is quite a big deal. He was coming into the natural. 18 harvesters have been killed here, 4 daisies, so this is quite, this is a lot of damage. He is up on supply, he should be able to clean this up, and the DT harassment will allow him to take the win, I feel. Oh, he has to be able to deal with this. These units, there's so many units, he's having a hard time. He should warp in maybe a DT to maybe help with it. The Immortal now popping out, not rallied though, so it's not in the fight. DT in the action now, and yeah, I think all this got tidied up as well, so pretty good deal. That workers killed. Daisy's killed a lot of workers. The natural nexus is so close to going down, it doesn't. And I'm sure he's going to try and target it down. He is. He will lose some units. There it is. And that does get cleaned up. We have another DT heading towards the natural. There is no turret there. There is enough energy for a scan, so I don't see that much damage being done. The turret now being assembled, but two kills. Scan's about to get dropped. There it is. And DT does get taken out. So there is 33 harvesters for the SDC, but he has a natural. And Daisy is short on income at the moment, so he can't really build his. Now he does. There we are. And the next drop incoming. Picking up some units there for nice micro, but it will go down. And not enough anti-air to deal with the medevac yet. Again. And he wants this. Nice. Another double medevac drop coming into the natural, and reactions from Daisy. He does react in time. I think this will get cleaned up pretty fast though. There we are. More units are coming across the map. The supply is both super close, but The SDC is still economically ahead, I feel. It's just because of the meals and the expansion really, really helps. If we look at the income, we can see, of course, the ECE has been forced to long distance mine, so it's just, it's not, like, economic. Or efficient, that's the word, efficient. Alright, so we have we have charge and production, of course, with the laws, that is a pretty good call, and a forge is research in plus one armor. Wow. It's only plus one armor, he hasn't got any other upgrades. Especially compared to the 1-1. And we have an extra eBay armory in production, so plus 2-2 will be started for the Terran play relatively soon. And the 7 supply in this. He should drop a marine and add on an extra marauder, but okay. We have some units coming into the natural. We have 4 medevac dropped incoming, 2 to the main, 2 to the natural. A lot of damage being dealt. The Stalker's getting taken out. Photon Overcharge is dropped onto this Nexus. The Immortal is going to go down. That is being targeted. It vaporizes. These units do get cleaned up in the main, and these units do get picked up. The one medevac is so low on health. Some nice target firing would take it out. There it is. These units do get clumped up. The Stalkers get taken out, so the anti-air is not able to take out the medevac, which is quite a big deal. Like, the Stalkers are so expensive, and he's dropping Marauders, which, you know, are so cost-efficient against Stalkers, but the medevac does get taken out, and this does get cleaned up. Daisy is ahead in supply. Behind this, the SDC is doing a good job of rebuilding his harvesters. And we have a DT Rugby here. It does get scanned. It might survive, but we do have some units. Charge is done, or... yeah, it is done. They were on move command. No attack move. We have 5 Stalkers. Feels like you just need more Stalkers. You need like 8 to pretty much nearly one shot the medevacs. And that hurts, man. Blink, I think, might be a bit more of a viable mid game tech just to deal with this, because there's so many medevacs. And this factory. Oh, look at those force fields. He is going to pick them up, though, the SDC, and save some of their lives. Boosts behind them. The factory lands, of course, that is going to bin the cooldown of the charge. Widow mines in production as well, which is a little interesting. And more force fields being dropped. Scan gets dropped. There is a DT here. 106 supply v 112 for the STC. And, you know, the STC is having really cost efficient trades here. Not, you know, he's losing health for pretty much units. And like, how long can Daisy carry on doing this? The factory now about to reduce the widow mine. It does pop out, and it does burrow. It is being targeted down. It does not get killed off, and of course this could do some damage to the units. Oh, a nice little hit there. The widow mine does go down. 20 supply deficit now for Daisy. The factory gets killed off, plus 2 armor in production as well, and this just about gets cleaned up. Daisy still behind supply. Units lost. Oh. These speed medevacs are just so much more cost efficient, and they're much more aggravating. And that's an interesting thing. Like, if you have boost and you're kiting, like, because the medevacs move so fast, they heal as well, and you don't have to worry about them lagging behind and getting picked off, which we see from a lot of in wall pretty much. That medevac does go down. Nice snipes here. Of course, if you get the medevacs, that stops the army being as cost efficient as possible. Because of course they're not getting healed, so that's big deal. Lag incoming for someone. Whoa, that's a lag spike as well. Nalan, bad Nalan, and yeah, big lag spike there. Scan gets stopped. Observer gets picked off. No more drops have gone to the main, but the third base has been taken for the SDC, so he's economically in a really good spot. Still 30 supply lead. It's getting bigger. Immortal in production, oh wow, he could warp in a crap ton of Archons, or High Templars. And the Nexus is getting targeted down. I don't agree with that, as there are still units here. He's not abusing, the medevac drops or anything like that. DT being added into the mix. The Immortal is about to join the fight. The Stalkers, they run off to the front, they can't, otherwise they will go down. We have like one Marine, so I don't know where the Mothership Core is, but it should be kind of in the fight. And DT dealing some nice damage. The DT should get spotted, and there's the scan, it gets taken down. And here we have a bunch of High Templars, 4 in total, still has 800 gas, so you can add on an extra 4 as well. Archons being most Archon charged a lot, there's still a powerful army. The gas geyser goes down, that's a big deal. And now it's a 50 supply lead for the STC. Some insane kiting, Jesus Christ, he's not allowing Daisy to pretty much get form. He's like not allowing them to stabilize, and he's just dealing a crap ton of damage. There is a DT doing some good damage in here. An extra DT scan gets stopped. There's not many Zealots, there's only one. And he leaves the vision of the scan. There are still DTs. And the Mothership Core is incoming. There are a couple of Marines here, so he has to be careful. It could drop a photon overcharge. There's the probes coming from the main towards the natural probes in here, still fighting. And 50 supply V130 STC has got this, it seems like. 31 Harvesters. The Immortal is one of the last fighting units. We do have a single Archon Morph in him. We could have enough of two more, but probes coming off for the last fight here. And ooh, looks like a couple of medevacs got taken out. GG is over.